Hello, this is the October Weather and Climate Outlook update for the grain growing regions of South Australia, Victoria and Tasmania. This outlook will focus on rainfall and temperature, including frost, in the next weeks and out to January 2024 to support upcoming decisions. The key messages for southern grain growing regions: as September rainfall to date has been below median for all three states, which was in line with expectations. It is shaping up to be one of the dry Septembers on record for some areas. A rainfall forecast in the next weeks to months continues to show below median rainfall. And in terms of temperature, we're expecting above median daytime and nighttime temperatures, but frost is still a possibility. Let's take a look back at what was originally forecast for September on the left-hand side, compared to what we did see for the month on the right-hand side. And overall, the expectation was for a drier than median month, and past accuracy was high. We can see that the model has done a decent job in capturing the dry month, and areas in brown shades have seen less than one-fifth of the historical mean rainfall. And unfortunately, there's no more on forecast for the rest of the month, but there is some on the horizon, which I will show in a moment. Less than 5 millimetres has fallen so far this month for most of the South Australian and Victorian Mallee, generally less than 20 millimetres for the Eyre Peninsula, and also northern and northeastern parts of Tasmania. We also did see some very high temperatures around the middle of the month that are worth noting, with places like Kimber, Cleve, Renmark and Mildura all setting early season maximum temperature records. That is, the earliest before summer, the daytime temperatures climbed to as high as 37 degrees. Looking now at current soil moisture levels, and we are continuing to see below average to very much below average soil moisture through South Australia and Victoria, as well as parts of Tasmania. And it is forecasting to rain this way heading into October. Looking now at the accumulated 10-day rainfall, comparing the EC model on the left-hand side and the access model on the right-hand side. And we do see large differences, and this is due to a potential rainfall event from the 3rd to the 6th of October. The EC model on the left-hand side is suggesting quite a widespread rain event for areas east of a line from about Kerrang down to Colac, and also some areas of higher rainfall for the lower and mid-north of South Australia, as well as potentially parts of the Mallee. On the right-hand side, the access model is showing the bulk of the rainfall falling to the west of a line from about Kerrang down towards Colac. So overall, it is difficult to make a firm comment beyond saying that model confidence is low at this stage, but most southern grain-growing areas do look to receive some rainfall, so this will be a watch point into next week. For the rest of October, and looking now at the chance of seeing above median rainfall, and there is a less than 30% chance of seeing above median rainfall for much of South Australia and Victoria. And this figure does fall to be below 20% for the Fleurieu, Coorong and upper southeast of South Australia, as well as southwest Victoria and the Mallee. And past accuracy based on historical model performance is high, above 75%. And it's the later part of the calendar year that models do traditionally tend to perform better. So we're expecting below median rainfall, but how much below median can be demonstrated by comparing these two maps. On the left-hand side is the October forecast that shows a 50% chance of receiving at least that amount next month, and on the right-hand side, the historical median. October is normally one of the wettest months for Southeast Australia, but we're expecting rainfall totals to be down on the median. On the left, the 25mm line runs from around Kingston in South Australia, across to Stawell and Woodend, and up towards Shepparton. But in a more typical October, this line runs further north, somewhere from around Murray Bridge to just south of Echuca. And this is the same for the 10mm and 5mm line, which are also expected to lie further south this month. Models don't quite capture individual weather systems very well, so the rain coming next week will be a real test of how much will fall in the gauge, but these maps can give an indication of the deficits we're expecting as a 50% chance. Looking now for November to January, and the chance of above median rainfall still shows that it is a low chance, and we do have high past accuracy based on past performance. We can compare what the other international models are saying, and this is an average of the US, European, Japanese and Canadian models for November to January, again looking at the chance of exceeding median rainfall. And it is still painting southeast South Australia and southwest Victoria as being a lower chance of exceeding median rainfall. And so this consistency with the access model does give an extra layer of confidence in the forecast. Looking at the frost outlook now, and there is an increased risk of frost in the week from the 8th to the 14th of October, as shown on the right-hand side, for parts of South Australia, Victoria and Tasmania. And this is following that potential rain event with some cold air behind that system. But what the map isn't showing is that the frost could potentially start as early as the 5th of October. And we are likely to see minimum temperatures fall to below 3 degrees and some areas below zero. And these experimental maps can provide a bit more of a guide as to what we're seeing the chance of seeing at least one frost is. On the left, the first fortnight of October, and on the right hand side, the fortnight starting the 8th of October. And this confirms that frost is still very much a possibility, with a 70 to 100% chance of seeing frost throughout the first few weeks of October, particularly through parts of southwest Victoria and also into parts of South Australia, and of course, across parts of Tasmania across both of these two fortnights. But we do see lower probabilities elsewhere, including the Eyre Peninsula and the Mallee. Looking now at the minimum temperature outlook from October to December during that critical frost period, and again it is showing that the chance of seeing above median minimum temperatures is quite low through parts of South Australia and into Western and Northwest Victoria, again showing that risk of frost is still very much a possibility through October. And we do have high pass accuracy. Looking now at maximum temperature outlooks all the way out to January 2024, and it is showing a very high chance of seeing above median maximum temperatures across all three states, again with high pass accuracy. But instead, we can also show this map here, which shows the chance of seeing maximum temperatures in the top 20% of historical figures to give an idea of how high the temperatures will be. And it is showing for most grain-growing areas of the south, we will see 2 to 3 times more higher chance of seeing maximum temperatures in the top 20%, with, again, very high pass accuracy. That's it for this Grains Climate Outlook. We'd love to hear more from you, so you can scan the QR code on your screen now, or visit the website to fill in a short survey about the video and send through any other feedback. Thanks for watching.